Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome back to the 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships from Sollefteå, Sweden. And this afternoon, the mid-distances continue, and our next event, starting at 11:40 Central European Time, will be the 10K Classical Technique Standing Men. My name is Randy Ferguson. It's great to have you all back with us for this last day of competition here in Sollefteå. It's been absolutely fantastic, and the racing this morning, very exciting, as Andrea Eskow picking up another title, and talking about picking up another title, Roman Petrushkov in the men's sit-ski event dominated the field once again. We will be starting here with Japan's Kenji Takagami, and going all the way down to Vegard Dahle, who right now leads the men's IPC World Standing with just a 54-point lead over the young Rushan Minegulov, who will be starting at two places before him. Also have another young Russian in this group, Vladislav Lekomsev. Then right after, we'll go to our men's visually impaired race, and our first starters will be Alexander Zaitsev and his guide, Nikolai Prichin. And a big battle to be hope for here, as Brian McKeever and his guide Eric Carlton are back from the Vassal Lopet on the weekend, where he finished an extraordinary 45th overall of 16,000 skiers. And so it'll be the Polukin McKeever battle once again. And also probably in the mix, we could see Stanislav Choklev and Sebastian Modin from Sweden. The snow has fallen again overnight. We've had about 4 to 6 inches of snow over the last 46 hours. Kind of odd after being right up into the plus 10 almost last week and raining. We're back into winter conditions. The men's race, as you see there, it is 10 kilometers, so two times around the 5-kilometer loop. And the women will complete later on one lap of the course. So we're just about to go here as we have our first skiers setting up in the start area. And we'd see right away Kenji Takagami of Japan, who will be our first skier out. So Takagami will be starting at 11:40 and 30 seconds. He'll be followed by Tian Ye of China and Cheng Shishui. And that is the order we have here. And I'm wondering, they're looking at that picture, if Tian Ye and Takagami have not changed orders there. So we'll see that very soon on our screen. So actually, we are going to start with 51 is Zhu Dexin, then Takagami, Du Heitao, Liu Jianhui, and then starting fifth will be Cheng Shishui. So first will be Zhu Dixin from the People's Republic of China. And just a reminder for all athletes, the course is now closed for training, as we are just about to get underway for this 2013 IPC Nordic Skiing last day of competition at these World Championships, and our 10K Standing Men Classical Technique is about to start. 10 seconds, announces the official. And there we are, Zhu Dixin from the People's Republic of China. We will then see Kenji Takagami, and he will start, as everybody will, at 30 seconds interval. And there is Kenji Takagami. And he is off. Next up now, number 53 from China, Du Heitao. It was great to see Dixin, Zhu Dixin, Du Heitao, Liu Jianhui, and Cheng Shishui take part yesterday in the team relay. A first for China, as here we have Du Haitao from China is now on course. LW57 class. Once again, this is a factored race. Depending on the level of disability, there is a percentage factor given to the athlete, and the times will be calculated in view of that, hence to create a level playing field for all athletes and giving them a fair size field to compete also. Number 54, this is Liu Jianhui. Now hearing the beep for the start is Tian Ye, also from the People's Republic of China. So in this start, five Chinese team members. So they'll be skiing in the classical technique for this race. And the last of the group right there, we see him at the start, is a Cheng Shishui, LW6, member of that relay yesterday. Skiing one of the top legs for his country. Tripping slightly here at the start is Argentina's Pablo Javier Robledo. Once again, it is a 5K loop, so we'll see these gentlemen come through once, lapping in the stadium, and they're going out for their last 5 kilometers to complete this 10K middle distance event in Cable, Wisconsin earlier this year. They took part. And it was a victory by Rushan. Sorry, this was in Vukati. Rushan Minigulov, just in front of Vladislav Lekomsev, and Jaka Tuomisto from Finland was also in that race. And earlier in the year, also we had an event take place, as I said, in Cable, Wisconsin. And Nils-Erik Ulset was the winner of that one in front of Marco Renz and Vigar Dale, who will be our last starter here today. As out of the start gate is the Ukraine's Vladislav Maestrenko. And off goes Maestrenko now. Ole Lesishin ready to go. Keiichi Sato now is on course. Yannick Boursault maintenant pour la France au départ. La médaille cette semaine ici du côté de Soleftio. And he is now on course. Benjamin Davier, his countrymate, will be next out of the start. Le prochain à prendre le départ, le compatriote de Boursault, Benjamin Davier. Boursault, qu'on a vu il y a quelques instants, médaillé d'argent au biathlon longue distance. Biathlon's long distance silver medal is Boursault just taking off now. So a no starter for Karachurin. So we'll go right away to Ihor Reptiuk, a man who's used to the podiums here as he picked up in the free technique, long distance cross country race, a bronze medal. Also a bronze medal in the biathlon short distance. And a gold medal in the biathlon middle distance. So this is one of the skiers to pay attention to, as he is a middle distance and short distance specialist. We'll watch him go. This is Ihor Reptiuk of the Ukraine. Taking off for Norway now. Håkan Åsrud. And Åsrud was with Dale Larsen and Ulset yesterday, winning the bronze in the open class team relay. Oleg Balukto now on course for that young and developing Russian team, going through a transitional period for them as they are seeing some young skiers develop very well. Only 1 year away from the home games in Sochi. It'll be an interesting selection process for the coaches of that nation, as a lot of young talent has developed over the last few years. Here is one of if we could call him veteran of this circuit, Ika Tuomisto. Tuomisto just off the podium in the long distance free technique ski earlier on in the World Championships. Now to the start, Vladislav Lekomsev. The cross-country sprint world champ. Very young, I think he's only 18 years old, Lekomsev. And he was also a gold medalist and part of the World Championship open class team relay from yesterday. Now Kirill Mikhailov will be our next skier out. No stranger to the podium in Paralympic Games and World Championships. Number 70 there, Kirill Mikhailov. Rushan Minigulov, another young rising star for the Russians. Silver medalist in the 20-kilometer free technique cross-country race earlier on. Bronze medalist in the sprint. So a strong performance by the young skier. And he was also part of that World Championship relay team from yesterday. Rushan Minigulov. Now we go to another LW57 skier, and this is Vladimir Kononov from Russia. And we'll be moving right away after our next skier into our starts in the blind and visually impaired men. This is a 10K classic style race. And they'll be off right after the finale here for the start in the men's standing. And it is Vegard Dahle from Norway who will close the deal here, seal the deal as they are all out on course. Well, the competition has started. And Dahle, a silver medalist in the sprint event, just by a hair behind Lekomsev. It was actually a photo finish finale. And now we are going to move on to our blind visually impaired men start. As none of our competitors in the standing have gone by the 5K mark yet. That will be happening relatively soon. So the IPC flag flying for one more day or one more afternoon here in Sollefteå, Sweden. And once again, we'd like to send out a big thank you and congratulations to the organizing team here in Sollefteå, the members of the Biathlon and Ski Club, all the volunteers, Mia, Hans and their team. Thank you very, very much. Without your help, we would not have had such a successful event. A lot of work has gone into putting on these IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships. Alexander Zaitsev and his guide Nikolai Prichin are just about to start. And they are off, our first skiers of the 10K Classic Technique Blind Visually Impaired Men's event. And next up will be Eric Bay and his guide Christian Mire Hellruth. And there we have Bay and Herud, who have now taken off. Third out of the start gate will be for Russia, Alexander Artemov. And he is being guided by Ilya Sherepanov. Next duo will be from the Ukraine. This is Reshetinsky and his guide Dmytro Kurtyk. So looking forward to the battle between Polukin. The expected battle, I should say, between Polukin and McKeever, as we send McKeever back.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
Back to the mix as we see Oleg Ponomarev and his guide Arten Veselov. Polukin dominating most of the biathlon events, winning the long distance, middle distance, and short distance in biathlon.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go.
As we see number 86 here, Filip Spitschin and his guide Alexei Kopitin. And Polukin not taking part in the sprinting. but still picking up silver in the long distance cross country race. So it's going to be a battle to the wire between Pulukin and McKeever once again. Let's see how close it will be, but we may have also some players changing the name of the game here, as we just saw Vasily Shapsiaboy and his guide Mihal Levezu from Belarus. You could also have an actor like Sebastian Modin or somebody like Yuri Utkin, who is the next up. Then there goes Utkin with his guide Vitaly Kazakov. And we have a visual now on our screens of our first skier coming through in the men's standing event. We'll see what the reference time is at the 5 kilometer mark. As we see starting right now, Alexei Toropov and his guide, Evgeny Fatkulin. And right there on Zhu's tail is Kenji Takigami from Japan. And you'll see them coming into the stadium very soon. Au départ maintenant, Thomas Clarion et son guide Julien Bourla. Et c'est parti pour Clarion. Only 4 more skiers now to take the start in the men's 10K Classic Technique event here. Now Sebastian Modin from Svaria, from Sweden, just about to start. And he is off. Sebastian Modin and his guide Alben Hakkerut is on course. Zhu Dexin completing the first 5Ks in 16:20.1. So he is off and on his way to complete his 10K race. Down the start gate.
3, 2, 1, go.
Russia's multiple biathlon world champion, Nikolai Polukin, is on course. And his guide, as usual, Andrei Tokarev. Takigami's time right now at the 5K mark, 16:52.4. That's 32 seconds slower than Zhu Dexin. Stanislav Choklev for Russia and Maxim Pirogov are now on course. And we have one more duo at the start in our blind and visually impaired category. As we see coming into the stadium right now is Pablo Javier Robledo. And I think he will be the owner of the new best time. Going through there, yes. By 14.8 seconds, 16:05 in front. So, going to our men visually impaired, we've just been told that Brian McKeever and Eric Carlton will not be taking the start here today. So, Polukin is in a position to win another world championship. And coming up to the 5 kilometer mark for our standing men is number 56, Cheng Shishui. So Shishui, will he have the new best time? No, but he will be probably second at this point, as Pablo Javier Robledo set the reference time. Yes, so he is 12 seconds behind Robledo. Xixue is 12 seconds behind Pablo Javier Robledo. Here comes number 59 now, Vladislav Mestrenko, and he will be way under that time. And he sets the new reference time. That is a 15:24.7. So 15:24.7 is the pace to beat right now to win the World Championships in the men's standing 10K classical style race set. Juan Hui just came in 8th. Sergei Silchanka for Belarus is 3rd presently. So Mestrenko, Robledo, Silchanka. Et maintenant, Benjamin Davier, et je crois que Davier va complètement anéantir le temps de Mestrenko, et c'est le cas. So, obliterating the time set by Mestrenko is Benjamin Davier from France, setting a new reference time, 14:39.0. And now, here comes number 60, Oleg Lesichin. He is 4th, 4th, 16:07, a minute 28 behind Benjamin Davier, who is the only skier under 15 minutes at this point. Keiichi Sato now, 3rd, 15:51.4, a minute 12 behind Benjamin Davier. So Davier, Mestrenko, Sato. Ior Reptiuk now. This should be a very good time. He is second, 5.7 seconds slower than Davier. Alors, en ce moment, Reptiuk à 5 secondes de Benjamin Davier. Et voici maintenant qui s'amène Yannick Bourseau. Voyons voir le temps pour Bourseau. Sera-t-il plus rapide que son compatriote? Will he be faster than his countrymate here, who is in the lead of this men's standing 10K. No, Bourseau, 9e présentement à 1:39 du meneur. 9th, a minute and 39 seconds off the pace of Benjamin Davier. Ior Reptiuk is 2nd, 2e, a 5.7 secondes, 5.7 seconds behind. Here comes it now. Vigar Dale. So Vigar Dale, we'll see what his time is as he comes. Oh no, this is Håkan Olsrud, I'm sorry. Håkan Olsrud. 3rd presently, 3e, 3rd. But now Vladislav Lekomsev and Kirill Mikhailov have just come through with the best times. So it is Lekomsev. Oh, Tuomisto, 2 for Finland. So Lekomsev, 13:53.6, the only skier under 14 minutes, has a 24.5 second lead on Kirill Mikhailov from Russia. Finland's Ika Tuomisto is 3rd, 41.5 seconds behind, pushing Davier to 4th. Now here comes Oleg Balukto, but he is off the pace right now, 6th, looking at a 1 minute 22 deficit on our leader Lekomsev. Will this be Minegulov? Yes, Rushan Minegulov now. Will he have it in him to take the lead from Lekomsev? No, he is 2nd, 2.8 seconds slower than Lekomsev. So it is Lekomsev with a time of 13:53. Minegulov, the only other skier under 14 minutes, is 2.8 seconds behind. And Kirill Mikhailov is 3rd, 24.5 seconds behind. So only two more skiers to go through here at the 5K mark in the men's standing race, being Vladimir Kononov of Russia and Vegard Dahle of Norway. And here comes Dahle right now. What will be his time? The time to figure amongst the top three here is at least 14:18.1. Anything over that and you are off the running for a podium after 5 kilometers. And this is going to be a pretty good time for Dahle, but he's not going to be top three at this point. Let's see once it gets factored in here with his class percentage. So he is seventh right now, 55 seconds off the lead pace with 5 kilometers to go. So it is Lekomsev, Minegulov, Mihailov that are in the lead. Lekomsev and Minegulov are separated by only 2.8 seconds. And Kirill Mihailov is 24.5 seconds back from his teammate and countrymate, Vladislav Lekomsev. That's the way they stand after 5 kilometers. We should soon see our blind and visually impaired skiers make their way here into the stadium, as they also have the same race distance to complete as our standing men. We will have as of 1 p.m. today, the start of the women's standing classical technique race. And then we'll have our blind and visually impaired women, as Elena Remizova will be part of the group, but especially Mihailina Lysova, who is turning out to be the queen of Soleftio, and a very interesting tuck position here by number 72 for Russia. That is Mr. Kononova, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, Vladimir Kononov of Russia. And here come our first skiers in the men's blind visually impaired race. Erik Bay and Christian Mir Hellrud. And right behind them, this will be number 84, Yaroslav Reshetinsky from Ukraine, and his guide Dmytro Kurtyk. Turning into a close race here. And here comes number 85, Oleg Ponomarev, who seems to have ditched his guide here. He was in a bit of a tuck and maybe in a bit of pain. And depending on what class he is, he can leave the comfort of a guide. And a visual here on number 82, Erik Bay. There they are into the stadium. That is Bay, followed right behind by Reshetinsky from the Ukraine. So the best time today belonging to Vladislav Lekomsev in the men's standing, 13:53 after 5K. And now they will be setting the reference time after 5K for the blind visually impaired race for men. So their time, 16:06.3. And Vladimir Kononov is sitting in 11th right now. And Yaroslav Reshetinsky posting a lead time now of 15:13.3. And Oleg Ponomarev just coming through now, 14:56.6. So he is the first athlete under 15 minutes. So Oleg Ponomarev is on his way right now. Still some of the top skiers to come. Clarion, Modine, Poloukin in the running. Choklev also. As we come to the midpoint of our blind visually impaired race. Still Ponomarev. Ponomarev leading. Now we'll see Zaitsev's time. Alexander Zaitsev is 2 minutes and 34 seconds back from his countrymate Oleg Ponomarev. And a whole group now making their way into the stadium. Alexander Artemov posting the second best time, only 1.8 seconds behind Ponomarev. And our next time, Yuri Utkin is in third. He is 2 seconds back from our leader Ponomarev, but only 0.2 of a second behind Artemov in second place right now. Shapsiaboy in fifth, 22.3 seconds back. Spichin in seventh, a minute 12 behind. So Ponomarev, Artemov, Utkin, only 2 seconds separate third and first. That's still some of our top skiers still to come based on the last week's result and this season's result. Now number 89, Alexei Toropov and his guide Evgeny Vatkulin. This is kilometer 5 of 10. Toropov's time looking to be probably third or fourth, maybe even fifth at this point. Very low factoring in for him, 98%. He's fifth, so 21.6 seconds off of the lead. And now we are waiting for our four fastest duos. And right now, dominating as he has done many a times, is Nikolai Polukhin from Russia. So Polukhin will definitely set the reference time here at kilometer number 5. Yes, 14.17.2. He is 39.4 seconds faster than Oleg Ponomarev of Russia. And now dropping to third, Alexander Artemov. And still two duos to come. Three duos, Clarion, Modine, and Tchoklaev. Et voici que ça amène Thomas Clarion. Serait-il en mesure de se hisser parmi les trois premiers? Reste à voir avec cette performance stellaire, incroyable de Nikolai Polukhin, qui mène par 39 secondes. So, Clarion really having the motor here if he wants to sit on one of the top three spots on the leaderboard. Here he comes, Thomas Clarion et son guide Julien Bourlat. 14.58, 4 et le temps aux 5 kilos pour faire partie du trio de tête. Alors, Clarion qui s'amène ici. Oh, ça va être tout juste. Il est donc deuxième. So, Clarion is second right now à 36 secondes du meneur, 36 seconds off the pace, pushing Ponomarev into third and Artemov off the podium at this point with only two more duos to come, that being Zvaryaz Sebastian Modine and Albin Akkerut, and Russia's Stanislav Tchoklev and Maxim Pirogov. And here we have right now in the stadium from Zvaria, from Sweden, Sebastian Modine and Albin Akkerut. Modine, what will be his time? Where will he sit after? He is in sixth right now, sixième, sixth. And here comes Tchoklaev, as we will also have our finish in our men's standing race. Our first skier to finish coming over the line now is Zhu Dixin, 32.068 for our first skier through here. Nikolai Polukhin, once again, is 6.4 seconds only in front of Stanislav Tchoklev, who just went through now. So it is Polukhin, Tchoklev, Clarion, dans cet ordre pour le top 3 chez les messieurs in our men's blind visually impaired mid-distance race. And giving it all he had here today is Pablo Javier Robledo. 31.50. And Robledo was sitting 13th last time we saw them at the 5K mark. And Vladislav Lekomsev was leading in front of Rushan Minegulov. And in third was Kirill Mikhailov. Working hard, Vladislav Maestrenko will be our next athlete to come into the stadium and complete his 10K race here today. Final day of the IPC Nordic Skiing World Championships here in Sollefteå, Sweden. And a big, big thank you once again to all involved making this event such a great success. And thank you for your loyalty and watching every day on the web these broadcasts of the World Championships. Alors, Benjamin Davier qui prend la tête chez les messieurs. L2A9, so in the standing category, Benjamin Davier, 28.47.2. 1 minute 24 plus rapide que Vladislav Maestrenko. Alors, pour Davier, reste à voir. Est-ce que ce sera une possibilité d'un top 3 ici pour lui? Il était cinquième au kilomètre numéro 5. So we'll see for Davier. Will it be a trip to the podium or at least a top 5 for the French skier here today? He was fifth after 5 kilometers. And now we will have number 52, Kenji Takigami from Japan. Fifth right now, cinquième présentement. And for the People's Republic of China, number 56, Cheng Shishui, fifth, so pushing Takigami back. Siari Shishanka from Belarus is fourth right now, 31.37.8. Ole Lesishin, who was 14th after 5K, is now in fourth. Ior Reptiuk has just set the new best time, 28.36.6. 10.6 seconds faster than Benjamin Davier. Here comes number 70. Voici le 70. This is Kirill Mikhailov. He had the third best time after 5K. He has given it everything he has, gritting those teeth, taking it to the end. Will he be able to climb the ladder here and hopefully maybe end up in silver or even gold? Right now, he has the new best time. But we still have the two fastest skiers from the 5K mark to come. Here's Vladislav Lemonsek. He has taken the lead in a time of 27.085. That is a full second, a full minute and 5 seconds in front of Mikhailov. So right now, we are waiting for Rushan Minegulov. We'll see what his time is, as we just saw Tian He from China come in a 34.076. And here comes right now down the final straight. This is 71 Minegulov, the time he has to beat, 27.085. What will it be here at the line? Second by 5 seconds. So Lekomsev, Minegulov, Mikhailov looking to be our top three here today. As I look down the list, I don't think we have another skier that could contend. Maybe Ika Tuomisto from Finland. Here he comes. He might be very close. He was in fourth place after 5 kilometers, making his way to the line. Ika Tuomisto from Finland. He is motoring here. Cheer him on, everybody. Can this be a bronze medal for him? Let's see as he crosses the line. He is really slowed down at the end there. He dropped to sixth from fourth. I thought from the way he was skiing there that he was right on track. But for Tuomisto today, it will be a final time of 29.083. Liu Jianhui now coming up. Here comes, également voici Bourceau qui était 17e au 5 km. Également, also in this group, Vegard Daly, he was 7th after 5 kilometers. Has he bested that? No, this is Håkon Ulsrud, I'm sorry. 30-38-2, number 66. And there is Daly. And Daly is in 6th place, 29-04-4. And that puts him at a minute 55 behind the winner. Oleg Balukto now is 8th, 2 minutes and 58 seconds behind. And that is pretty much it, folks. The final standings will probably be Vladislav Lekomsev picking up his second individual title, 27.08.5, 5 seconds behind Rushan Minegulov, and in third place with a deficit of 1:05, Kirill Mikhailov. And in our men's blind visually impaired race, as we see the rankings now, Lekomsev, Minegulov, Mikhailov. And in our blind visually impaired race, after 5 kilometers, Polukhin had only 6.4 seconds up on Stanislav Tchoklev. Et Thomas Clarion était troisième à 36 secondes du meneur, 36 seconds off the lead. But still in the game, Oleg Ponomarev only 4 seconds behind the French skier, and Artemov still very much in it. He is almost tied with Yuri Utkin, and Sebastian Modin from Sweden still in the running for a bronze medal. So fans of all ages joining us here today in Sollefteå for these IPC Nordic Skiing World Championship. Maybe a former skier there, as we see Tuomisto refueling after his race. And our racers are now coming into the stadium. First and foremost with Yaroslav Reshetinsky from the Ukraine and his guide Dimitro Kurtik. They were 8th, 50 seconds off the pace. Eric Bay and his guide Christian Hellerut, 11th after 5 kilometers, and still going strong in the men's standing race is Du Heitao. Oleg Ponomarev now sounding like he's cheering his guide on almost at this point, telling him don't give up. Fast skier he is. Yaroslav Reshetinsky now coming into the stadium. He will set our reference time. What will it be here? They completed the fastest time in the 16-minute range, in the 14-minute range, I should say, for the first 5K. Reshetinsky is posting a time of 30.12.7. So Reshetinsky and Kurtik, 30.12.7. Here comes Bay, and Bay will set a time of 31.25.7. He was 11th at the 5K mark. This is Oleg Ponomarev. So Ponomarev was 4th, and this is important. He needs to push here, knowing that a potential bronze medal awaits him. He's presently 2nd, so that will push him back 6.7 seconds slower than Reshetinsky. And here we come. This is our final competitor in the men's standing. A good round of applause here for Du Heitao from the People's Republic of China. So Reshetinsky's time of 30.12.7 is the time to beat. And now Yuri Utkin, sixth after 5 kilometers, is making his way to the finish line. Will he upset the order here that we've had for the last few minutes? And yes, Yuri Utkin has now posted the new best time, 29.32.8, and he's pushed Ponomarev way back already. So a very satisfied Yuri Utkin and his guide Vitaly Kazakov. Now, here come the Belarus. These gentlemen have already won Paralympic medals. And this is Vasily Shapsiaboy and his guide Mikhail Lebedzu. They really have to motor here as Shapsiaboy has moved ahead of his guide. And we'll see what will be his time here at the end. It will be 30.045. He has moved into second place, already picking up a medal this week. Will this be his second? He won bronze in the biathlon short distance. Here comes Poluk, and this will be the final reference time for the books. This is a time of 28.012. Yuri Utkin, a minute 31 back, sits in the silver medal spot right now. Vasily Shapsiaboy is third with a time of 30.04.5. But still, we have not seen Thomas Clarion de la France or Stanislav Shoklev of Russia, who were respectively third and second at kilometer number 5. Spichin now coming to the finish line was 12th and sits provisionally right now in 7th. Alexander Artemov being cheered on by his guide. And Artemov coming in at a time of 29.27.8. He has just moved into second place. Alexei Toropov is seventh. So we have a new second place contender, a new silver medalist contender here in Alexander Artemov. Let's see if it will be enough, as we will have our last skier today in the men's standing event, Vladimir Kononov, making his way here to the end. Let's give him a big round of applause, everybody. A big cheer for Vladimir Kononov of Russia, completing his event in the men's standing class. And over the line, and for Kononov, it will be good for 12th place today in a time of 30.56.9. So in the blind visually impaired, Polukin, Artemov, Utkin, Zaitsev on his way to the finale, still looking for Clarion, Modin, Choklaev. Now we do have a visual coming out of the forest on Alexander Zaitsev. Zaitsev, first time around, was 13th, so not a contender here today. But his presence means that we will soon see these skiers ranked third and second at the 5 kilometer mark. That being from France, Thomas Clarion avec son guide Julien Bourla. Voyons voir si ces messieurs on continue sur la cadence qu'ils avaient établie lors du premier tour. Ils étaient troisième. So they were third. Zaitsev coming in 10th place right now. They will drop probably a couple of positions based on Bourla's, or three positions, because Modin was also in there for Sweden. And here we have a beautiful race here between Thomas Clarion and Stanislav Shoklaev. Right behind them is Sebastian Modin. So this one's going to be finalized right at the line. Alors, une course ici effrénée pour une place sur le podium. This is going to be an all-out battle right now, as you have Shoklaev and Clarion right behind Modin. Shoklaev looking to garner a silver medal maybe here. Let's see. Thomas Clarion and his guide Bourla not giving up, but Shoklaev seeming to be the faster skier out of the woods here. Here they come. Stanislav Shoklaev, to hope to win silver today, will have to have a time that betters the 29:27.8 set by Alexander Artemov. Et pour les Français Clarion et Bourla, pour espérer une médaille de bronze, voyons voir, possiblement 29:30. Oh, est-ce qu'on est piégé ici un peu de la part de Clarion? Oh, let's see, as they come to the line, what will it be? Shoklaev, second. Et pour Clarion et Bourla, cinquième. Fifth. And Sebastian Modin from Svalia is in fourth. So Nikolai Polukin in a time of 28:01.2. Stanislav Shoklaev in second, 28:35.5. Alexander Artemov and Ilai Sherpanov are bronze medalists. So a beautiful performance. A very fast ski by Artemov and Sherpanov on the last 5Ks to pick up bronze. Sebastian Modin and Albin Hakerut are fourth, and Yuri Utkin is fifth. And Thomas Clarion et Julien Bourla terminent sixième aujourd'hui ici à Soleftio. Donc Polukin, Tokarev, Shoklaev, Pirogov, Artemov, Cherepanov. Another Russian sweep here in the men's visually impaired 10-kilometer race. Our next start, scheduled for 1 o'clock at Central European time here in Sweden. It will be our women's standing event. And we will complete the day and these championships with the blind, visually impaired, middle distance classical technique. And we will see that IPC, International Paralympic Committee flag, come down from the poles here, as this will conclude our world championships here in Sollefteå. But what an amazing few days of racing it has been for Irina and the members of the Russian team. They are fine-tuned, and they'll be showing their colors very soon at home as they move to the test, the Paralympic test event in Sochi in a couple of weeks. And also prepare for the Paralympic Games that, as of Thursday, will be starting in 1 year already. So it is now our time here, 12:34. Racing starts at 1 p.m. We're going to take a short break, everybody, and come back to Sollefteå for our last two races of the World Championships. And we'd like to thank one and all who have been watching these races over the last few days via the YouTube channel. It is YouTube.com/ParalympicSportTV. And we thank you very much for your attention and loyalty. So as we've seen throughout this race, an amazing acceleration by the great Nikolai Polukin. It was his moment to shine, especially with the no start from the Canadian duo of McKeever and Carlton. It opened the way for another title for Nikolai Polukin. And he was very satisfied with that performance. And he knew that it was another gold medal. We'll be right back, everybody, for our racing here at 1 p.m. Be back for our women's mid-distance classical technique standing and blind visually impaired races. We'll be back at 12:55.